Good day everyone, it's me Amir Amin and I'm going to present my article. The topic of my article is Difference in Breastfeeding Practices Among Urban and Rural Mothers in Lahore, Pakistan. So I would like to start from the introduction. What is actually breastfeeding? Breastfeeding is the process of feeding the infant with mother's milk, either by direct nipple baby mouth contact or by expressed milk, breast milk. During the first 2 or 3 days, watery and yellowish fluid that comes from the mammary glands differs from the regular milk and is called colostrum. It is secreted in small amount and rich in protein and having less fat content, and the mature milk is whitish milk that is effectively produced from about 10th day following delivery. Summary of my article is exclusive breastfeeding. EBF is the practice of feeding the infant for the first 6 months of life on breast milk only, without any other type of food and fluids, not even with water. EBF is recommended as the best feeding alternative for infants up to 6 months and has a protective effect against mortality and morbidity. Colostrum is important for the baby as it contains more protein, immunoglobulins, IgA, lactoferrin, white blood cells, vitamin A, zinc and less fat. These are important for an immune defense of the baby during the initial days of life. It also contains an interferon-like substances which possesses strong antiviral activity. Exclusive breastfeeding is associated with multiple advantages to both the baby and the mother. On the baby's side, there is the acquisition of passive immunity against infection, nutrients for physical and mental development, emotional security and closeness to the mother. During a dynamic and physiologically sensitive process, breast milk production is adjusted to suit the infant's requirement according to environmental changes. For example, breast milk will contain more fat during cold seasons. For which I conducted my study was, it has been observed that large number of 0 to 5 years old children are admitted in the hospital of various respiratory and gastrointestinal illnesses every year. This number is increasing day by day. Large proportion of this is seen in urban areas and most of them do not receive breastfeed. There was a need to assess the breastfeeding practices so that the appropriate measure could be taken in order to lessen the number of children experiencing these illnesses. The objective of the study was to assess the breastfeeding practices in rural and urban nursing mothers and to evaluate the determinants of selected key indicators of breastfeeding practices in both rural and urban settings in Lahore, Pakistan. There was a need to assess the breastfeeding practices so that the appropriate measure could be taken in order to lessen the number of children experiencing these illnesses. So the material and method that I used during my study, first of all, the study design that I used was a descriptive cross-sectional design, and for that, just for the sake of data collection, the tool I used was a self-administered questionnaire that I used to collect the data, and my study area was Karol Bagh, which was a rural area, and the Shalabagh Teaching Hospital Lahore was located in the urban area. Sampling method that I used during my study was purposive convenience sampling, and the sample size of the study was 370 females of having 0 to 2 years old children. After the analysis of the data, the results that I concluded, 30%, 111 females belong to age group 20 to 25 years, 39.7%, 146 females belong to age group 26 to 30, and the rest 30.3%, 113 belong to age group 31 to 35 years. 20%, 74 females are residents of rural areas, whereas most of the females, 80%, 327 females are living in the urban areas of Lahore. 30% females are housewives, and 30.8%, 114 are working in the government setup, and 38.9%, 144 females are employed in private organization, whereas only one female is working as a maid at home. Only 40.8% females which is very less number, are giving breastfeeding to their children, and the rest 59.2% were not giving breastfeed. 23.5% mothers who are self-motivated for the breastfeeding, and they were self-motivated in the decision of providing the breastfeed to their children. 30%, 111 mothers reported that they observed a change in cholesterol in first 24 hours. 98.6, 365 mothers are satisfied with their professional and marital life, and 1.4%, 5 mothers are found dissatisfied. 38.9%, 244 mothers are able to manage breastfeeding, whereas the rest, which is a very high number, 61.1%, 226 females are not able to manage breastfeeding. So it is a common cultural belief that the initial breast milk is dirty and not nutritious, and therefore has to be supplemented with prelactial feeds like honey and goji. Findings were consistent with that of Ashraf et al. Also, early introduction of foods leads to various allergies in later life. The breastfeeding mother needs to understand the supply and demand concept of milk production. A positive feedback loop stimulates the breast to create more milk. This is a positive feedback mechanism of production of milk and release of milk. Actually, I would recommend that the focus must be shifted towards diet, local birth attendants that are present at the time of birth, and so can utilize the opportunity to initiate breastfeeding early and avoid the use of prelactial feeds, because it can induce allergic reaction in the later life. So these are the references, and before the references I would like to share the conclusion of my study. This study is able to show the status of exclusive breastfeeding observed are influenced by factors like education, employment status, affordability, and so on. It can be concluded that a large number of females, especially those who are living in the urban areas and working for 6 to 8 hours a day, cannot manage breastfeeding along with the work. There is a strong need for the development of policies by the government agencies to allow mothers with infants to avail maternity leave in order to provide exclusive breastfeeding to the children. Since some private organizations do not allow for non-maternity leaves, moreover, awareness campaigns should be initiated to provide necessary information about the advantages of breastfeeding and effects of not breastfeeding to the children. Implications of the findings and the study. Aforementioned results clearly shows that there are still large number of mothers, especially those who are living in the urban areas and are working females, working mothers who are working for 6 to 8 hours, do not practice exclusive breastfeeding despite of massive awareness campaigns and so on. More funded studies can be conducted with the help of some female co-researchers, since it is hard to collect such data by a male researcher due to cultural considerations. Major limitations that were faced by me during the study while conducting the study were collecting data especially from only those mothers who had delivered a baby within last 1 year. After finding such mother, collecting such information due to hesitation and cultural considerations. Another limitation of this study is generalization. And the references that I used during my study are Clara, Kjellberg, Elizabeth, Horn, Vedanta, Offender, and Anjam, Kutsia, Shfaq, Tabinda, and Siddiqui, Hamna. Knowledge regarding breastfeeding practices among medical students of Ziauddin Medical University. Thank you very much.